got the Arri Mini balanced on the standard Helix. We'll run you through how we've managed to balance it. We've got the LMB5. We've got three C-Force Mini motors. They are lightweight. We've got the 28 to 76 Ingenue Optima Cine Zoom. And we've got the Cine tape mounted on the back with some dual lock. And then we've got the TerraDeck on the other side right over here. Again, we've connected that and mounted that on with some dual lock. We are using thin BNC cables. Those are the ones that I advise to use with the system. We've mounted the Arri Anton Bauer power plate on the roll axis over here. And we're using the Anton Bauer HC Dionic batteries. In order to get some more weight at the back, we've connected one juice box battery over there, another one down here. You can actually just have two batteries ready there. Once one of them dies, you're ready to go without having to change batteries. You can just swap the cable in. I've got some shoulder mount weights, which look like this. This is one of the weights that I've got for this rig that I've got somewhere. So I've taken that off and I've basically mounted this underneath like that. And what I've done is I've taped that underneath in order to increase the weight at the back.
It's intended for communication. It's a form of language.
I've attached the horns for the Cine tape right at the top over here. Hot swapping C-Fast cards is quite easy. Keep some distance between the back of the Mini and the rods. Open up and just position your C-Fast card in like that. And push in and then just close. And that's your card changed. The plate that Arri provide with their camera systems also have, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 RS outs. And then you've got one D-tap at the back right over here. You've got 2-pin LiMo outs at the bottom of the Helix roll axis over here. You can power accessories via that. You can power a TerraDeck or possibly even a Cine tape or whatnot, but you have to have custom cables made. It's a reverse polarity, so make sure to use cables that are ideally supplied by Lettuce. Otherwise, you risk shorting something. Starting from the tilt axis, you've got some markings over here, so whatever camera system you balance, definitely remember how you've balanced it and just mark it up and make a note of that. You've got markings on the roll axis over here as well, so you can make a note of that as well. And then on the base plate, you can clearly see where your camera can fit on the base plate as well. You can mark up where, in between which number your camera system sits over here. You've got markings on the pan axis down here as well, so you can make a note of all three axes where you should line up the Helix in order to balance it. This Arri Starlight monitor is touchscreen, and you just press it over here. And you've got an Arri menu button over here. You press that, and then if you just move with the arrows over here, you've got control over frame rates, you've got control over the shutter, and you've got control over the exposure index. You've got built-in NDs, which you can have control over. The white balance, it's a wonderful monitor. It's very lightweight, it's very slick, very clear. You've got an SD card slot there. You can record on the monitor.
It's intended for communication.